Hi, I'm Rick Emerson, and welcome back to Outlook Portland on Northwest 32 TV. We're here with Mr. Willy Vlautin. He is the author of books such as The Motel Life and North Line. He is also the singer-songwriter of the band Richmond Fontaine. A lot of writers will begin with a character, somebody who appears to them, or a scenario or a question. What would happen if? When you sit down to write, do you start with anything in particular, or is it just a sort of just a notion, just a general direction?
No, I mean, I usually have the story worked out in my head. You know, the general, like if I told you a novel in a bar story, say over a beer, that's what I start with. Like, I have the general overview and I have the heart of it. Again, like, it's if you hear a song and it really moves you, the way that song feels, I try to get that feel in a story, just like what I want the whole story to feel like. And then I get the overview story, and then I just start whittling away at it. To me, writing novels like working on a car, trying to get a car to start, and you just keep tinkering on it, and you might not know what you're doing, but you don't give up on it, and you just keep tinkering on it, and then hopefully, you know, eventually it'll start.
Yeah. With a novel, for example, as opposed to a short story, when you sit down, you've got the first blank page to the last word of the last draft, how long does it typically take you?
It all depends. Like Lean on Pete, my latest book only took a couple years because I knew the story pretty concrete, and the kid was really the narrator's really cool kid. He wasn't a train wreck mentally, and so it wasn't very taxing. I really liked him. Like, getting to be around him every day was a gift. So I plowed through it. It just depends what you're working on, how intense it is, and how hard it is on you mentally.
Is it more taxing? Is it more difficult to write novels, to write fiction, than it is to write songs?
Songs are like, for me, again, I mean, my songs are pretty dark, so I always write from a certain side of me, generally. So usually if I'm a train wreck, if you see me and I look worse than I do right now, then I'm probably gonna write a song, you know. Usually when my life's falling apart or you know, I'm spinning some darker way, I'll write songs. And then when I'm like got my act together and more solid is when I write novels. So it's the same side, but it's usually songs are way more dramatic.
So is it fair to say, so if somebody listens to a song that you've written, is it fair to say that that's a snapshot of where you were in your head or in your life?
Yeah, I mean, the themes, my songs, my stories, they all live in the same block, really. I mean, they all could live in each other's houses. My songs are a lot of time soundtrack to the novels. So it just depends. Yeah, they're more dramatic snapshots, but it's the same ideas. You know, I have the same heart in both of them, and the same things trouble me, or the same stories I want to tell, or ideas I want to get across. And novels take years, and so you write a lot of songs during the headspace you're in one novel.
You talked about your characters all sort of living in the same block, and the type of guy, the type of figure you're attracted to in books or in songs. Is that drawn from where you came from in your life, from your childhood, or how you grew up, or do you think you're just hardwired to write that way?
That's hard to say. I mean, I grew up with my mother and my brother, and she worked the same job for 30 years or so, and so it was a stable home. I always assume, I guess I could say my mom was obsessed with being broke, and she was really scared of being on the street, and she knew how easy it is if a few bad things happen to you, or if you lose your job and a few bad things happen, that you can end up with nothing. So I think I was always instilled with, like, you better watch out or you're gonna end up a bum. And I think at an early age, I realized that I could end up like that, and I might. And so I just go, well, all right, then don't be scared of it. Go see what it's about. And so in high school, even, I was hanging out at old man bars. And you know, when you're young, that stuff's really romantic and it's funny. And you're like, these guys aren't so bad. I could end up living like this. And then it's only when you get older, you're like, holy hell, I hope I don't end up like this. And so, I mean, just all those kind of ideas is where I write from.
Dealing with that kind of terrain that is bleak, that is grim, does that increase or alleviate that sense of gloom. Is it depressing to write about guys in those scenarios?
Oh,
or
no,
is it cheering?
I mean, they're like my friends, you know, like Allison Johnson in Northline. I mean, I worried about her every day. I mean, I'm crazy. I think they're real, you know, and I never think they're depressing. I think I admit things that most people think, you know, and I don't think they're depressing. You know, I think they're hard stories, but a lot of people live hard lives, you know, and I'm just trying to tell my version of those kind of stories.
We're talking with Mr. Willy Vlautin. You are watching Outlook Portland right here on Northwest 32 TV. Stay right there. We'll be back.